Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today let's look at the best antivirus software for your Mac. MacMost is brought to you by a community of more than 350 supporters. Find out how you could become a part of it at MacMost.com/Patreon. So I often get asked, what's the best antivirus software for my Mac? A lot of times people say, look, I just don't feel comfortable not running antivirus software, or my company says I have to have it on my computer, so what should I get? So you're not really looking for antivirus software, you're looking for anti-malware software. A virus is just one type of malware, and it's rare today. Most malware today are Trojans. These are pieces of software that you install yourself because you've been tricked into downloading software from a site you shouldn't trust. Sometimes that software itself is malware. Sometimes the malware comes along for the ride when you install the software. Now you want to prevent that malware from getting on your Mac. So what software should you install? Well, the good news is that the best software for the job is already on your Mac. It's included as part of macOS. For years now, Apple has included anti-malware software built into the operating system. They don't talk about this much because, of course, they don't want to publicize that part of it, right? They don't want to talk about how there are Trojans out there for the Mac. They just quietly build it into the operating system and it protects you. Now, this protection software is in three parts. So the first part is called Gatekeeper, except you won't find something called Gatekeeper anywhere on your Mac anymore. If you go to Apple Menu, System Preferences, and then you go to Security and Privacy, and you look under General, there's a section here called Allow Apps Downloaded From. Years ago, they actually had a little icon there and they called this Gatekeeper. So that's what people still refer to it as. Now it's just some settings here. You can't even actually change them unless you authenticate. And then you have two options. You can only allow apps to be installed from the App Store, or you can allow apps from the App Store and from identified developers. Beyond these two options, you do actually have the ability to install any software you want as long as you give it permission. So this is like your first line of defense. If an app's in the App Store, then it was submitted by an identified developer with a developer account with Apple, and Apple reviewed it before they allowed it in the App Store. It's not a perfect system, but it does allow Apple to check for a lot of things, including whether it represents a security or privacy vulnerability, and just some quality guidelines that Apple has. If there are problems, Apple can actually pull it out of the App Store and take away the developer's ability to produce new apps in the App Store or even as a signed developer. Even if the app is from outside the App Store, if it's a signed app, that means a developer is part of the Apple Developer Program. There's been some identification checks and Apple can revoke that. So there's some level of security with just signing an app. So Gatekeeper is kind of a gateway system. It just prevents things from getting installed. So if you're not that tech savvy, then you should definitely set it at the lowest level. Have it only allow apps from the App Store. And even if you set it to the other one, you should always question whether or not you really need an app and whether you really trust the site that you're downloading from. If there's any question, just don't do it. Now the next part of Apple's anti-malware system is called XProtect, and you won't find any mention of it anywhere official either. It's built into macOS and you can actually check to see that it's there and that it's been updated. So what XProtect does is it prevents you from installing some of the worst pieces of malware out there. And it does this in the same way antivirus software works. It has these little identifiers that identify if a piece of software is bad, and it will then prevent it from being installed. You can check in the Apple menu about this Mac, click on System Report, and then look on the list on the left and go under Software to Installations. And then you're going to get this long list, and if you look all the way under XProtect, you'll find a bunch of XProtect plist config data entries. And the most recent one is the one that you want, and you can see right here that version 2102 installed on April 19th. Now if you want, you can actually find XProtect just to see that it's there. So in the Finder, choose Go and then choose Computer. Dig down into your hard drive and then System and then Library, and under there look for Core Services. And you'll look there and you'll find one called XProtect. If I control click on it and say Show Package Contents, I can look in Contents, Resources, and I could see a XProtect plist and XProtect Meta plist. And under Meta, I can see here in the little preview that the version is 2102 right there. Under the other one, I can open it up just by hitting the space bar and look at it in Quick Look. And you could see all these different definitions for different pieces of malware. So if I looked for something like a dictionary entry here under description, I can see in the string there's the name of it. If you actually search for that online, you might find a little bit about that piece of malware. Here's another one. And here's another one. Alright, so Gatekeeper prevents you from installing something that you probably shouldn't. XProtect is the next line of defense, making sure that even if you give it permission, it's not going to let you install some of the worst malware that's out there. What's beyond that? Well, there's something called MRT, which is the Malware Removal Tool. And this is an app that's on your Mac that will actually remove pieces of malware. You can also find that if you go to About This Mac and then System Report, and then look under Installations, you'll find MRT config data and a version number there and a last updated date. In the Finder, if you go into your computer and then System and then Library, and then from there you also look in Core Services, that's where you actually find MRT. So how do you run MRT? Well, you don't, and it's kind of a mystery as to when it runs. There's some people that say it runs every time you reboot your Mac. If you have malware, if you simply do a restart of your Mac, it may get rid of it because MRT will trigger then. Other people say it runs whenever there's an update. So you do an update and then it will run and scan your drive and look for that malware and remove it. Now, to keep XProtect and MRT updated, make sure that under System Preferences and Software Update, click on the Advanced button and make sure you have Install System Data Files and Security Updates checked. So that's Apple's three-part anti-malware system built into Mac OS. It won't protect you from everything. You can still go to a site that you probably shouldn't, download a piece of software that you definitely shouldn't, install it and give it permission to install, and then you might be stuck with something like some adware that actually shows ads or changes how Safari searches and things like that. So you could still be the weak link here. Only install software that you're absolutely sure you need and it's from a site or service that you know you can trust, and always keep your Mac updated.